Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Vlogmas. I have both kids napping, so I'm trying to be quiet. I'm basically gonna do kind of like a Christmas prep brain dump right now with you guys in hopes that it will help you along with your Christmas preparations and really for me so I can get everything that's in my brain kind of down on paper and see what I've done already and what I have left to do. So last Vlogmas, I started off the whole, you know, series with this Christmas prep list that I made. I mean, I had a like 3 week old baby, so I really needed to like write out what everything I needed to do. So on this, I sort of broke it down into things to bake, things to decorate, things to do, things to wear, and things to give. And looking back at last year, sort of comparing this year to last, I've already done most of the things on this list, so that's pretty great. But some of the things I want to finalize is Christmas clothing, because we have a couple different events. Evie has a Christmas program at her school that we all go to, and then me and Evie and my mom are going to the Nutcracker Ballet again, and then we have a Christmas service at our church. So we have quite a few events where we kind of want to dress holiday-ish, and I have all the outfits I need for the girls and for Luke, and I have my one plaid dress that I plan to wear. I don't know if I'm gonna wear it to all of those, probably not. I'll probably wind up wearing, you know, a different dress of mine to one or the other. They're kind of with different groups of people, so I can probably get away with re-wearing that same plaid one a couple times because I do love it and it's festive for this season. So that works for me. The thing with the girls is I wanted to check and see if I had tights for them. I looked for new ones for Lara at Walmart, and she's a size, you know, 3 to 4, so she's kind of in between the toddler section and the big kid section, and they just didn't have her size in like the thicker cable knit tights. They had the really thin sort of like pantyhose, but that does nothing in the winter time, so I was kind of bummed about that. So I may keep looking or just see what I already have on hand. I might have some tights that she can wear. And then for shoes, I did just get them both brand new boots from my favorite brand, L'Amour. That is where I got Evie's school shoes last year, and they were having promotion. These were on clearance half off, so I basically like buy one, get one free. And so that's what they'll probably wear, you know, when it's really cold outside. They'll probably just wear their really cute boots with their dresses, and that's good for me. As far as gifts for the girls, they're pretty much done with all of their main gifts. The one thing I do still want to get for them is like new art supplies. So construction paper and tape and just things that they can manipulate, you know, pipe cleaners, all things like that. They kind of really need a refresh stock of all that. So I'm definitely going to be getting some more of that. It's just hard to shop for those things when I have Lara with me, you know, most places that I go. So I might have to just run out, you know, on a night when Dan's home with them. Maybe I'll sneak out and try to go pick all those things up. I do also still have to figure out what I'm doing for Evie's teacher and for our neighbors. The teacher, I might just do a gift card because apparently that is what they really want. So it's easy for me and I know that she'll appreciate that. And then for our neighbors, I really don't know what I'm gonna be doing. I love to go and check out World Market because they have a lot of unique gifts that are kind of, you know, from around the world is the whole point of it. And that's actually where I got those really cute maple syrup tins that I gave last year. So I might go make the drive over there and see what they have. We also have a new Trader Joe's around us, so that is another option. It's not that close, so our neighbors may not have been there yet. So that might also be like a little bit special because it's kind of a unique store. Now, as far as baking, I do like to bake cookies this time of year. You guys saw my ginger molasses cookies that I made. And then I also made some cream cheese cookies, confetti cookies, which are so delicious. I'll put these links down below. I do have a couple batches of those already frozen, and I did make a batch of the Andes mint cookies, which are again one of our favorites. So those are already in our freezer, sort of ready for those last 2 weeks of Christmas. And then I want to make some rosemary shortbread, which I think I've shared that recipe on this channel also. That is one of my all-time Christmas, you know, favorite Christmas cookies. So I do want to make some of those. And we have a cookie exchange that's coming up next week. I only have to bring 2 dozen cookies, so that's really not that much. But that is another thing to consider. I don't know what kind of cookie I'm gonna bring for that. It's for kids, so I probably wouldn't do the rosemary shortbread for that. We might just do another batch of the Andes cookies because I'm sure they'll appreciate that. And then my family does a Secret Santa, like I mentioned, so I have to still shop for my Secret Santa. And Dan has to, you know, shop for his as well. So those are really the last gifts that we need to buy. We sent off the gifts that had to be sent out. So I wanna also show you in this video what I am putting in Dan's stocking. My friend Maureen from The Magical Mundane Life, I was supposed to be participating with her in a collaboration last week, and I had to email her and apologize that, you know, I had sick kids. I literally couldn't get out to just browse a store and look for these things. So I told her I'm going to post it when I have everything. So I was able to finish out shopping for his stocking. So I'm going to show you real quick what he is getting. Okay, so for Dan's stocking, first thing is this stormproof match kit. So inside, I think there's 25 matches. They're windproof and waterproof. I found these at Walmart in the camping section. And then a similar gift, this is a fire starter. He does like to go camping, so I thought those might be handy. And then he also loves to do off-roading, and I like to get him a magazine because he would never buy this for himself. And it's nice to sort of just roll it up and stick it in the stocking. His hands get very dry in the winter, so I thought this was a nice thing that he can keep on his bedside table, a night treatment. A lot of times he gets in bed and he's like, oh, I wish I had lotion. So rather than, you know, go to the bathroom to get the one we have in there, this will be nice. He can just have it just for himself. It's sort of an intensive dry hand treatment. This is just sort of a practical gift, again, from Walmart. It's a two-piece magnetic tray set, something he can keep in the garage, sort of stick it to his toolbox, and then when he's working on something, these will help to keep all the screws and nails and things contained so he doesn't lose anything. And of course, what's a stocking without treats? So this is one of his absolute favorites. It's like a popcorn, caramel popcorn with like butter, brown sugar. It's delicious. And then he likes these little gums that you can stick into like your car console and the cup holder. So I got two of those. I'll wrap those up together. This is his all-time favorite candy. And again, he really would never buy it for himself. So I got the extra large one. He loves Werther's Originals, so I got those for him. Some of the Haribos in the Christmas colors and some Milk Duds. And yes, we do wrap our stocking stuffers just because it's sort of prolongs that fun of opening it and being surprised. So I do have to go ahead and wrap each of these things individually. But I am missing one more thing that I got for Dan a while ago, like a month ago. I bought him a burger press. So it like shapes a burger patty into like a perfect, you know, thickness and size. And I literally can't find it. I have no idea where it is, but if I do find it, that will also be in his stocking. All right, so I think that is everything that I kind of had on my brain, the last minute things I need to take care of, just so that I can really, really enjoy those final like 10 days of Christmas leading up to it, and I'm not rushing to buy last minute presents and, you know, having to wrap last minute, which is what we always do. But we did start wrapping and I'm hoping to do some more today. So hopefully all of that will be done before that last week of Christmas as well. I hope this video was helpful to you guys as you are doing your Christmas preparations, and I will be talking to you very soon. Take care. Bye.